I am Ganesh Beaglave, working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this session of the heat exchangers, we will see LMTD approach for counterflow. Learning outcome. At the end of the session, students will be able to derive LMTD relation for counterflow. So we are going to continue the LMTD approach. Now the flow will be counterflow. So as usual, the tube in tube type of the structure is there. So this is the inner tube, this is the outer tube. In the counterflow, the cold fluid direction will change. This is suppose a THI, THO. Now the flow of cold fluid will be in the reverse direction, counter direction, opposite direction. So this is TCI, this is TCO. We can plot the temperature distribution for this counter flow. If this is THI, as the heat transfer is taking place, there will be decrease in the temperature of the hot fluid and the outlet temperature will be THO. The cold fluid inlet temperature is TCI. As it flows in the counter direction, it will gain the heat and that's why there will be rise in the temperature and the living temperature is TCO. Now, the counter flow heat exchanger gives the TCO temperature depending upon the length of the heat exchanger, may be equal to THO, less than THO, and if the length of the heat exchanger is much more, we may get TCO greater than THO. Keep in mind. And also try to see such type of the flows in day-to-day life. That means in the actual practice. Now we'll write the heat transfer rate equation, which is equal to minus m dot h cph into bracket THI minus THO. Now as we have seen already, in terms of heat rate will be equal to CH into del TH. So for DTH we can write Q divided by minus CH. Similarly for cold fluid it will be equal to minus M dot C CPC TCO minus TCI. For heat rate it will be minus CC into DTC. So for DTC we may write minus Q by CC. Since the temperature difference is theta between the hot and cold fluid, so it is a TH minus TC, which is also equal to del T. Taking the differentiation of d theta in differentiation form, which will be equal to dTH minus dTC. So substituting the relation for dTH and dTC, so d theta is equal to minus Q divided by CH minus Q divided by CC. Now here minus minus will become plus. Here we can take Q common, minus Q into bracket 1 by CH minus 1 by CC. Suppose this is the equation number first. Since Q is equal to U dA del T, which is equal to U dA theta, because del T is equal to theta, here also we can write theta. Now substituting Q in equation number first, then we can write Q is equal to minus U dA minus U dA into theta bracket CH minus 1 by CC. Now let this as B. So Q is equal to minus u dA theta into B. So this relation can be written as so this will be theta, this is theta d theta. So d theta by theta is equal to minus u b into dA. Now taking integration from theta 1 to theta 2, and this is from 0 to a. So after taking the integration ln theta o by theta I, which is equal to minus u b into a. Now substituting the relation for b, so this will be minus u a into bracket 1 by c h minus 1 by c c. Since from this relation of q, which is equal to minus m dot h c p h into bracket t h I minus t h o, so this c h is nothing but m h c p h, we can write 1 by m dot h c p h is equal to t h I minus t h o by q. Similarly can be written for 1 by m dot c c p c is equal to t c o minus t c I by q. Then the equation 2 will become ln theta o by theta I is equal to, as it is minus u a we have written, then instead of 1 by c h we can write t h I minus t h o by q minus 1 t c o minus t c I divided by q. We can take a q common here and we can simplify it like ln theta o by theta I, which is equal to minus u a, q is taken common, into bracket, it will be t h I minus t h o minus t c o minus minus plus t c I. Now rearranging the temperatures t h I t c o and minus u a by q into bracket t h I minus t c o minus t h o minus t c I. Now this theta I is t h I minus t c o, and theta o here is t h o minus t c I. Okay, so we can write here minus u a by q instead of THI minus TCO, THI minus TCO theta I into bracket theta I minus instead of THO minus TCI theta O. So this is theta O. Now we can take minus sign here, so it will become minus minus plus UA by q into bracket theta o minus theta I, and in the left hand side it is ln theta o by theta I. So for heat transfer rate we can write q is equal to u a into theta o minus theta I by ln theta o by theta I. We can also rearrange the terms and can get theta I minus theta O, and here theta I by theta O, there is no problem. So this is similar with Q, UA del T m. Remember, this del T m is nothing but LMTD. So LMTD approach for counter flow, the relation obtained is del T m is equal to theta o minus theta I by ln theta o by theta I, which is also equal to theta I minus theta o by ln theta I by theta o. So if inlet and outlet temperatures of both fluids are given, or we can easily measure it also by using the thermocouples, then we can use this equation for finding the LMTD, log mean temperature difference. We can substitute here, the Q will be known to us, U we can take from the table, and in this fashion we can find out the surface area of the heat exchanger. Then this helps us for deciding the size of the heat exchanger. For the references, you can have Fundamentals of Heat and Mass Transfer by Frank and David, the Willey publication.